Hey everybody, it's Brenda Adelman, and this is day 20 of Forgiveness with Brenda. I'm proud of myself for doing this for 20 days. A live stream, I've gifted my program, Phoenix Rising, a 30-day journey into and through forgiveness to everyone who signs up for it. We're on week three now, we're just finishing up week three, day 20, hence day 20. But for those of you who maybe missed it or didn't sign up for the lessons go to your inbox, and you can get those through a link on my Forgiveness and Freedom Coaching page. I'll also post a link underneath this live video. And you can still get when you sign up today, that'll be day 7 of this theme, which is on forgiving your father. You'll get all the lessons from the week. They'll be at the bottom of the email you receive tomorrow. The emails go out at 10 a.m. Pacific Standard Time, so you'll get the lesson for the day and then all the lessons from the week. And then you'll still be with me for next week, which is the theme of forgiving God. That's an interesting topic, especially at this time, kind of especially when you're dealing with anything rough in life. I was interviewed by Martine Lopez yesterday with some other wonderful guests, and that video is also on this page. It was like a masterclass in forgiveness in a way, just with the level and depth and honesty of the sharing that we did, and also sharing all of us that were on there who've been on this kind of inner fitness path have been, sharing the ups, the downs, the things we've done wrong and what we've done right. And hopefully there'll be something on there that will resonate for you. And you can be like, oh, right, I can think of this differently. I know the people who were on there live really appreciated what we were sharing about, really deep stuff. This week is forgiving your father. Although I'm open to actually helping anyone with whatever you have a need of forgiveness for when you show up on these live streams at 1 p.m. Pacific Standard Time every day. I have another 10 days. Tomorrow I actually have to come on a little later. I'll probably come on at 1:30 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. I'll email everybody who's getting these lessons because I'm doing another interview right before, and I want to make sure that I come on time. I'd rather just tell you guys it'll be 1:30 Pacific Standard Time tomorrow, okay? Let's see. What else? So today's about setting healthy boundaries. Also, for those of you who don't know, the reason I started teaching about forgiveness and why I'm so passionate about it is because in 1995, my father, who I adored, shot and killed my mother, who was my best friend. And then within a month moved in with my aunt, my mother's sister, and they got married. He also went to prison. I also took him to court for wrongful death, but I did it from a place of forgiving. I did that, actually. Here's a setting a healthy boundary. I did that from a place of self-love. I did the forgiveness work before that, forgiveness of him and forgiveness of myself, so that I could actually make the decision to take him to court, not from a place of I hate him and I'm going to punish him. We talked about punishment last night on the call. And I also didn't not take him to court because I didn't know what a boundary was. Also, in taking him to court for wrongful death, there was a boundary that was placed that I didn't even realize at the time I didn't have. Like, because he skipped town, I never saw him again because we won a fairly large judgment that we didn't collect. But in order not to collect, he disappeared. And so the boundary was set. Like, I no longer had to think about, will I answer my father? Will I not answer a phone call? Will I call him? Will I not call him? Oh, I had the window open because it sounds so beautiful with the birds. We have a garden back there, but I see my housemate actually must have gone to the store and gotten some fertilizer or something. So there's some major activity going on out there. So, say hello, whoever's here. If you're on a replay, say hello. If you have any questions about boundary setting, healthy boundary, hard boundary setting, the lessons from 30 Days of Forgiveness. Hey there. The lessons from 30 Days of Forgiveness with Brenda come from my program, Phoenix Rising, a 30-day journey into and through forgiveness for your freedom. That is the program. It's a couple of $100. I made it free for this month because of everything everybody is going through, And so you will want to sign up for these lessons if you want to learn really the technique that I have applied to my life so that I could forgive the unforgivable. So what happened is when I forgave my dad for taking my mother's life, it didn't mean I was condoning what he did. It didn't mean that I gave him a free pass to hurt me anymore. Thank you for the comments. And listen to the content if you're here, because this is about a serious subject matter, okay? This is about forgiving the unforgivable so that we are all healthy, emotionally healthy, so that we can, you know, keep healthy, keep our immune system up. So what I can do, what I can offer is my course that I've put, it's free, it's my gift. It is my gift to everybody this month. Then it'll go back for sale. But every day this month, I have been sending these lessons to your inboxes and then coming on a live stream here on Forgiveness and Freedom at 1 p.m. so that I can answer your questions, add more value as far as bringing in what we are living through today so that the lesson of the day can also be anchored in. So today is about setting healthy boundaries. I taught about this last week when the theme was about forgiving your mother. And in the lesson in your inbox, you get more stories and examples this week about forgiving your father and what that means. Setting healthy boundaries versus setting hard boundaries. Hard boundaries sometimes being where you have to cut someone out of your life if they are stepping all over your boundaries, right? That level of codependence or that level of you should feel like I feel that you might have towards someone else if you're not setting a healthy boundary or they have toward you. Or that feeling, boundaries are so important. The only reason I could take my dad's court for wrongful death is because I learned what a boundary was for the first time in my life at 30. It's like, I didn't even know what it was. And most people don't because they just model whatever happens in their family or their family of origin. So if you have any questions about this, let me know. Let me see what I can share. I don't want to go over the lesson because the lessons are for you to sign up through the link and get them in your inbox. And this way I can also continue to support you. And, you know, when I'm doing live streams, when I'm doing challenges. I did a free 5-day self-forgiveness challenge a couple of months ago, things like that. And of course, I work with clients. I have a low-cost program called the Freedom Circle. This month is all about raising your vibration so that you can deal with this crazy freaking time in a way where you don't get so off-put by all the changes and all the stories that just kind of rip at our hearts or feeling powerless or feeling like, well, this is BS or feeling like it's this person's fault or that person's fault or this party's fault or this country's fault. It's like instead it's about coming together, and going through this life together in a sense of community. The Freedom Circle is a very safe space. It's not open social media where anybody can post whatever they want. It's a safe space to share from your heart, to really get feedback from me as a coach on what you're dealing with every day. Right? Because we're dealing with this virus, but we're also dealing with our lives. We're dealing with the people in our lives. We're dealing with our businesses or lack of business. We're dealing with, you know, family members that we want to see or we don't want to see. We're dealing with people that we're with in close proximity and dealing with the nature of our communication and things like that. Thank you for the heart. So that's what the Freedom Circle is about. That's a 3-month program. We're halfway through month one, but it's okay. If you come in this month, you'll still get access to the Raising Your Vibration training and the private group. And I'm doing a group coaching again this Friday, 12 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Oh, yeah, I'm doing it at 12, yeah. So, and then I'll jump on here at 1 unless I have to move that live stream. And then next month is about forgiving your most challenging relationship, with a focus on siblings. I've worked with a lot of people over the years who have had major issues with their siblings. And of course, it always comes back to forgiving yourself and setting boundaries and finding love where you can't find love and also embracing your anger in a healthy way so that you don't just spiritually bypass or compartmentalize because that steals joy from you. But it's all about your health. And then month 3 is about, which will be June, that will take us to June, is all about forgiving yourself for not being in alignment and living on purpose. And that could be in your business or in your relationship or where you are, your status right now. I think being isolated is really interesting for a lot of people that I've spoken to who, for all of us though, to reevaluate and evaluate even. We have a moment to stop and evaluate, where are we? Where have we gone off course? And so month three is going to be really exciting because there's actually going to be a lot of visioning in there. And I think it's going to be an even richer training based on what I'm learning about myself, having more time with myself right now. So today is about setting healthy boundaries. So, and I would love some comments here as far as, and this can be for the replay if you're watching it, like, do you know how to set a boundary? Do you know what boundaries are? Are you codependent? Do you know what that is? Do you believe other people should think like you? Do you enforce? Are you righteous about how other people should think? Do you look at the people in your intimate circle and is it healthy? Is it interdependent? Or do you isolate? Do you feel bad about something that you've that happened in the past and you haven't handled it, so you're projecting it out onto the other people in your life? Like, this is some serious teaching and learning, specifically around the boundary setting. That's why I teach about it all the time. I could not have taken my dad to court for wrongful death if I didn't know what a healthy boundary was and that I had no boundary with him. Or that, and I teach this a lot, I first had a hard boundary with him, and that is when you cut someone out of your life, and then they're still in your head so much that you're still hurting yourself, but you are the one hurting yourself with that. You're the one. Like yesterday, someone was sharing about how can she let go of her righteousness, and because she's just so angry at these people who were doing something bad. So it's not saying, oh, I have no discernment. You still know that they're doing something that you don't agree with. But the anger, the righteous anger we have hurts us, hurts our immune system, hurts our relationships. It's like expressing the anger when it's needed, where it's needed, and if it's needed. Personally, what I do with clients and what I've done a lot of is expressing my anger, not to the person I'm mad at, but on the pages of a journal in a technique that I call freeform writing that I learned. That's what I do, because there's no use in doing it towards someone who's going to be defensive and not be able to hear you. And there's no use, there really isn't, in just saying, oh, it doesn't mean anything, because that shows, you know, when we suppress that anger, and this takes so much conscious awareness. It takes you having your witness there, watching what your thoughts are thinking, but we all have access to that. If we just say, okay, whatever, I can't express it, so I'll just put it to the side, it shows up as addiction. It shows up as mistreating other people or mistreating yourself. I mean, that's the bottom line. Or sickness, illness, isolation, depression. That's it, if you don't do this work. That's how it shows up. Many studies on this. So it's really important to not just bypass that you're upset about something, but it's also important not to hurt someone else or hurt yourself because you're not dealing with it. So if you need a therapist, go to a therapist. Certainly when I was in the throes of what was going on in my life and I didn't know about all these tools that I teach now, I went to therapy, I went on shamanic journeys, I went to acupuncture, I did everything I could to support myself because I learned to love myself enough to get the support I need. So this is my way of helping to open up your minds, your hearts to yourself and look at this. Maybe look at this in a different way than you've ever looked before. If you want more help with this, I hope you'll join me in the Freedom Circle. That's where I can really coach you specifically on what you're dealing with. This month is actually about raising your vibration, and that's what the training is on. But it's also about, what do you do when your vibration isn't high, when you're depressed, when you're anxious? So that's what we talk about in that group. Like, how do we acknowledge it and then move to the other side of it? Okay, so if you have any questions, let me know, tag me. If you have any comments, if you have any insights, this is about community and conversation. It's why I'm doing this every day this month. And I invite you to sign up for the free training. This week's training is all on forgiving your father. I learned how to forgive my father for shooting and killing my mother and then marrying her sister. And when I did, the love for myself started to fill me up and my life looked differently. I attracted people who were not victims because I was no longer a victim. I empowered myself to tell my story on stages all over the world without hurting myself, without exposing too much, but really helping people, which is so important to me, one of my values. You know, so many good things happen once I learned this process of forgiveness and setting healthy boundaries. Okay, so I'm going to run and have a, hey Karen, I'm actually going to run. Unless you have a question, do you have any questions? Today's about setting healthy boundaries. I'll just wait for a second because I've been on here talking for a little bit and it's so beautiful out. I think I want to go outside today. I'm not going outside a lot. I'm going to hopefully go on my bike ride today. That's my mental health ride that I do every day, except when it's raining. It was raining for a few days here. I was thinking how funny it is I've been wearing this jacket every day because I get so cold. And then I wore this shirt, I think in one of my videos yesterday, but then I took it off. I'm like, this is a really weird time because I'm not really, you know, like I'm changing and I'm like, I'm not really going out and doing things, but I swear I am changing my clothes. I have a lot of calls and things that I'm doing and coaching. It's really interesting for all of us, right? How busy we can be despite the fact that being able to go out and just kind of go for drives or, you know, go have fun. We can't really do it outside and yet we can be so busy. I'm looking at that. I mean, this is a time to just slow down and say, where's my priority? I feel like I'm actually more clear-headed. So like with my business, I've launched a new program last week about how to be really yourself on video. And I find I'm much more focused. Like I don't get as like going to that project and this and that. Like I'm finishing things in a much more peaceful way. I'm watching my thoughts on, oh, I'm so busy, right? I think friggin', if not half the population, probably more than that, that's their story. I have so much going on. I'm so busy. I got to do this. And I, every time I go into that place, I slow down and say, is that true? No, it's not true. Do I have things going on? Yes. And then I shift also to, I'm really excited to create something new. I'm excited to reach more people. I'm excited to connect through video. So I, you know, I created the course. The irony is I created the course to help people who are really in a hard spot with business because they now have to get on video. So whereas before they might have wanted to, but now they have to. I created it for that so they'd feel comfortable. And yet the bonus for me is like I got to spend an incredible weekend with incredible new people and be on video connecting with them. Freaking fantastic. So that I also am not feeling so alone while giving value. All right. I don't see a question. Have a blessed day. Karen, write me in the group. The Freedom Circle. And that's it for today. If you have any questions about setting boundaries, let me know. And of course, you can just ask me in the group or comment below here. If you comment below here, I'll answer for other people as well to get an answer to this. Thank you everybody for watching, for stopping by. And if you're on the replay, please let me know. Okay, blessings.